I flew in 2015, and my roommates and everyone I'd selected when I was back home in India. So a lot of people have, I mean, there is a community at Podio, there is an Indian community at Podio, and people are really helpful. So the grad students initially helped out all the new admits. I mean, when we were back in India, there are Facebook groups when we can where we can connect to grad students at Podio. And then once the new admits kind of connected on Facebook, we had our own WhatsApp groups and everything. So there were enough people for us to find roommates back home in India as well. How do you look for places over here and everything? So Purdue itself is a university town. It's based in a university town. So the typical problems that you have concerning safety and accessibility and stuff like that, those are not relevant to Purdue itself, because almost everything on campus is within a 2 mile radius and from the university buildings and stuff like that. The cost generally tends to range from something around $800, $750 or $800 per month to $1,200, depending on how you spend. You can it is very much possible to get by with $800 per month over here. So it's not expensive compared to the standards over here. The housing is something like you pay in a twin sharing room also, you end up paying something like $450 and you get your own room. And in if you are sharing a 4-bed apartment with 4 people, then you end up paying something between 350 or 400. Oh no, so Purdue rules dictate that it's compulsory to get the insurance that the university is providing in which is by United Healthcare. So all of you just have to get the plan that the university is suggesting. You can purchase it from the university website. They have a special Purdue students plan, and in very rare cases they do allow you to get something from outside, but you kind of need to sit down with them and provide some documents proving that it's at least equivalent to the plan that Purdue is providing. So the university has its own healthcare center. Everything in there is covered by this plan that they have. So students generally don't want to tend for anything other than the university provided insurance. Annually, it's something like 1300 or something, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, 13 or
Okay.
1500, I think, annually. I didn't feel any homesickness as such, but definitely you do realize that it's different and it's a lot quieter. I took time getting used to the silence over here. And when I first flew in, that was almost, I think, 2 weeks or 15 days before classes started. So at that time, since it's summer break, you don't have a lot of students on campus. And in the evenings, you're walking down the streets. I was scared for the first week or so because, I mean, walking for 1 mile or something, I see buildings, I don't see any people around. And that can get intimidating at start. But I think with time, most of these universities have a really good student culture and community that you kind of gel in and you don't feel that homesickness. Regarding food, we also have an Indian grocery store over here, and that's, I mean, quite literally on campus, so you don't need a bus or anything to get there. Well, for anyone who really likes having food outside, maybe you have a big you will notice a big difference over here, because I mean, at our university we don't have any Indian restaurant. So if we want Indian food, we need to drive down to Chicago or Indianapolis. I mean, an hour and a half away. That's almost 60 to 80 miles away. So you don't have that luxury of having restaurant style Indian food every day. So you need to be able to cook. But if you are okay with having Mexican or Italian food every day. It's not a problem. You can have food outside. It's not that expensive also. Unless you are cooking completely at home, only then you are saving money from not having outside.